I'm Tamika Catchings. I went to University of Tennessee. Currently play here in Indianapolis for the Indiana Fever. I have my own foundation called Catch the Stars Foundation. My father played in the NBA for 11 years.
So we pretty much thought that that was just normal, you know, to wake up, go out on the court and play as a family and, you know, go to my dad's games.
I want to follow my dad's footsteps and I want to be in the NBA because the WNBA wasn't around.
Growing up, Mika having speech impediment, hearing problems, braces, glasses, pretty much anything that kids could use as a target to pick on, she had.
Taja was the one that actually talked for me. I didn't like the way I talked. I didn't like the way I sounded. It really kind of motivated me to play sport. And the one thing that I wanted the most was just to fit in.
I think I kind of tried to step in front of her and speak out for her just so that she didn't have an opportunity to be teased or picked on.
People would make fun of me, and I would always be like, okay, you make fun of me here, well, let's go play basketball. Because I guarantee I'm gonna beat you. And if I don't beat you, I'm probably gonna knock you down and knock you out because I had a bad attitude back then.
Since Mika was basically in seventh grade, she wanted to play for Coach Summit. She wanted to be a Lady Vol, and she did it.
When you go to the University of Tennessee and when you play for somebody that has had the success that she's had, you wouldn't go there if you didn't want that discipline, if you didn't have high expectation.
Coach Summit actually taught her, instead of hiding her disability, taught her to make that front and center and use that to her advantage. And use that to be something that would encourage other kids with disabilities and other individuals with disabilities, you know, to show them that they could do whatever they wanted to do too. Back in 2001, when Tamika was drafted here to play for the Fever, she had torn her ACL, so she wasn't able to get on the court and make an impact on the court with the team, but she still wanted to kind of leave her mark and make a difference here in the Indianapolis communities.
I told our community relations director, I said, look, whatever appearances you have, just put me in there. I did pretty much any and every appearance that you can imagine, I did that first year.
The foundation was actually started with us doing basketball camps.
From there, it's like we did the basketball camp, then we added the fitness clinic, then we added mentoring programs, then we added, you know, back to school celebration. So we've kept adding different things over the years.
The kids get so excited to see her and to be around her. She's at camp before it starts and she's there after it ends. She is just extremely dedicated. She's the type of person that really tries to develop a bond and a relationship with each of the kids that she reaches.
After doing like one of our first holiday camps, I remember watching a little girl. And then the mom ended up coming up to me and she was like, oh, you know, my daughter really looks up to you. She had to deal with a lot of the things that you dealt with when you were younger. She wore the big hearing aid too. So she became my little sister and she grew up playing basketball. And we still stay in touch.
I've coached for 42 years and I don't know that I've ever coached anyone that has such a tremendous work ethic. If she's not here on the court practicing or playing, she's out in the community giving back. And she does that at the same high level that she competes.
My passion is to help these kids. All my dreams and my goals that I set when I was in seventh grade, like they're all coming true. And I want to be able to do that for the next child.